In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones, who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon Lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family. which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. द डायरेक्टर टिम बर्टन वेगस अ वायलेंट बैटल टू शो अस न्यू एंड वंडरफुल थिंग्स इन हॉलीवुड दैट प्लेसिडली रिसाइकल्स द सेम ओल्ड इमेजेस. बर्टन यूजेस स्पेशल इफेक्ट्स एंड विजुअल ट्रिक्स टू क्रिएट साइट्स दैट हैव नेवर बीन सीन बिफोर. दैट इज़ द गुड न्यूज. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a sporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones, who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where haunting gothic castles crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer, Caroline Thompson, go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins. Except in pure action films, situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search, and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones, who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb. A goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins. Except in pure action films, situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search, and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb. A goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shade everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She bustles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, विंसेंट प्राइज, एलन आर्किन, सिनेमाटोग्राफी बाय स्टेफन कैजापस्काय, एडिटेड बाय रिचार्ड हेल्से, कॉलिन हेल्से, म्यूजिक बाय डैनी एल्फमैन, डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड बाय 20th Century Fox, रिलीजिंग डेट 7th December 1990, रनिंग टाइम 105 मिनट्स, बजट $20 मिलियन, बॉक्स ऑफिस कलेक्शन $86 मिलियन. द डायरेक्टर टिम वर्टन वेगस अ वायलेंट बैटल टू शो अस न्यू एंड वंडरफुल थिंग्स इन हॉलीवुड दैट प्लैसिडली रिसाइकल्स द सेम ओल्ड इमेजेस. बर्टन यूजेस स्पेशल इफेक्ट्स एंड विजुअल ट्रिक्स टू क्रिएट साइट्स दैट हैव नेवर बीन सीन बिफोर. दैट इज द गुड न्यूज. द डिसअपॉइंटमेंट इज दैट वर्टन हैज़ नॉट येट फाउंड द स्टोरी टेलिंग एंड करेक्टर बिल्डिंग स्ट्रेंथ टू गो अलॉन्ग विद हिज पैक्टोरियल फ्लेयर. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects. Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountaintop high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know, वट दैट इज द हीरो एंड द विलेन मीट, देयर इज अ डेडली कन्फर्नेशन एंड नो प्राइजेस फॉर गैसिंग हु विंस एक्सेप्ट इन प्योर एक्शन फिल्म्स. सिचुएशंस यूज्ड टू बी सॉल्वड बाय डायलॉग एंड प्लॉट डेवलपमेंट्स नो मोर. नाउ समवन इज किल्ड एंड दैट्स द सोल्यूशन एंड द मूवी इज ओवर. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search, and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque cue of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a sporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones, who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins. Except in pure action films, situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is P.V. Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search, and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb. A goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her. and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Denise D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones, who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon Lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search, and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1899. 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a sporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones, who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where haunting gothic castles crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon Lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice. And Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures, all of the central characters in a Burton film. PV, the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman, the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search, and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands. Another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world. वेयर हाउंटिंग गॉथिक कैसल्स क्राउचेस ऑन अ माउंटेन टॉप हाई अबव अ स्टोरी बुक सबर्ब अ गोफी सिटकॉम नेबरहुड वेयर ऑल ऑफ द हाउसेज आर शेड्स ऑफ पेस्टल्स एंड ऑल ऑफ द इनहेबिटेंट्स सीम्स टू बी इमोशनल क्लॉन्स ऑफ द जेटसन्स द वार्मेस्ट एंड मोस्ट ह्यूमन रेजिडेंट ऑफ दिस सबर्ब इज द एबॉन लेडी played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor, played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie, and if you like this movie review you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews, and watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson, story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson, produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton, starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky, edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey, music by Danny Elfman, distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990, running time 105 minutes, budget $20 million, box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon Lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things. in Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a sporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones, who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon Lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins. Except in pure action films, situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame, it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search, and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands. Another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb. A goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search and you will यू विल गेट दिस मूवी इन एनी ओ टी प्लेटफॉर्म. इफ यू लाइक दिस मूवी रिव्यू यू कैन डेफिनेटली सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू रिव्यू मूवी नेम्ड एडवर्ड सीजर हैंड्स. सो दिस मूवी वॉज रिलीज इन 1990. मैनी पीपल वॉन्ट्स टू नो वेयर दे विल वॉच एडवर्ड सीजर हैंड्स मूवी. सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टेल यू वेयर यू कैन वॉच दिस मूवी एंड इफ यू लाइक दिस मूवी रिव्यू यू कैन लाइक अवर वीडियो एंड सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल फॉर मोर मूवी रिव्यूज़ एंड वॉच टिल द एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू वॉच दिस मूवी. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. Releasing date 7th December 1990. Running time 105 minutes. Budget $20 million. Box office collection $86 million. The director Tim Burton wages a valiant battle to show us new and wonderful things in a Hollywood that placidly recycles the same old images. Burton uses special effects and visual tricks to create sights that have never been seen before. That is the good news. The disappointment is that Burton has not yet found the storytelling and character building strength to go along with his pictorial flair. That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects, Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones, who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where haunting gothic castles crouches on a mountain top high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon Lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution, and the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel. In this video, we are going to review movie named Edward Scissorhands. So this movie was released in 1990. Many people wants to know where they will watch Edward Scissorhands movie. So in this video, we are going to tell you where you can watch this movie. And if you like this movie review, you can like our video and subscribe our channel for more movie reviews. And watch till the end if you want to watch this movie. And this movie was directed by Tim Burton. Tim Burton is an American filmmaker. He is known for his gothic fantasy and horror films such as Beetlejuice, Edward Scissorhands, The Nightmare Before Christmas. So like these movies, he is directed. Screenplay by Caroline Thompson. Story by Tim Burton, Caroline Thompson. Produced by Dennis D. Nobby, Tim Burton. Starring Johnny Depp, Winona Ryder, Dane West, Anthony Michael Hall, Kathy Baker, Vincent Price, Alan Arkin. Cinematography by Stephen Kazapsky. Edited by Richard Halsey, Colin Halsey. Music by Danny Elfman. Distributed by 20th Century Fox. रिलीजिंग डेट 7 दिसंबर 1990, रनिंग टाइम 105 मिनट्स, बजट $20 मिलियन, बॉक्स ऑफिस कलेक्शन $86 मिलियन। द डायरेक्टर टिम वर्टन वेगस अ वायलेंट बैटल टू शो अस न्यू एंड वंडरफुल थिंग्स इन हॉलीवुड दैट प्लैसिडली रिसाइकल्स द सेम ओल्ड इमेजेस। बर्टन यूजेस स्पेशल इफेक्ट्स एंड विजुअल ट्रिक्स टू क्रिएट साइट्स दैट हैव नेवर बीन सीन बिफोर। दैट इज़ द गुड न्यूज़। द डिसअपॉइंटमेंट इज दैट वर्टन हैज़ नॉट येट फाउंड द स्टोरी टेलिंग एंड करेक्टर बिल्डिंग स्ट्रेंथ टू गो अलॉन्ग विद हिज पैक्टोरियल फ्लेयर। That was true even of his Batman, which was 1989's box office champion, but could have been a better film. I believe if there had been anyone in it to inspire our emotional commitment, even comic characters can make us care. Unlike Richard Donner's original Superman, which actually had a heart beneath its special effects. Burton's Batman occupied a terrain in which every character was grotesque of one shot of another, and all of their actions were inspired by shallow melodramatic motivations. That movie was stolen by a supporting character, Jack Nicholson, Joker, and now comes Edward Scissorhands, another inventive effort in which the hero is strategy remote. He is intended, I think, as every man, a universal figure like one of the silent movie clones who exists on a different plane from the people he meets in his adventure. One problem is that the other people are as weird in their ways as he is. Everyone in this film is stylized and peculiar, so he becomes another exhibit in the menagerie instead of a commentary on it. The movie takes place in an entirely artificial world, where a haunting gothic castle crouches on a mountaintop high above a storybook suburb, a goofy sitcom neighborhood where all of the houses are shades of pastels and all of the inhabitants seems to be emotional clones of the Jetsons. The barmest and most human resident of this suburb is the Ebon Lady, played by Dan Beast, who comes calling one day at the castle. Not even its forbidding facade can deter her, and finds it occupied only by a lonely young man named Edward, played by Johnny Depp. His story told in a flashback is a sad one. He was created by a mad inventor played by Vincent Price, who was almost finished with his task when he died, leaving Edward with temporary scissors in place of real hands. One look at Edward and we see that scissors are inconvenient substitutions for figures. His face is a mass of scars, and he tends to shed everything he tries to pick up. The Avon lady is not fazed. She buzzles Edward into her car and drives him back down the mountain to join her family, which includes daughter Kim, played by Winona Ryder, and husband Bill, played by Alan Arkin. The neighbors in this superb and insatiably curious, led by a nosy neighbor named Josie, played by Kathy Baker. The movie then develops into a series of situations that seems inspired by silent comedy, as when Edward tries to pick up a pea. Successful satire has to have a place to stand and a target to aim at. The entire world of Edward Scissorhands is satire, and so Edward inhabits it rather than taking aim at it. Even if he lived in a more hospitable world, however, it is hard to tell that satirical comment Edward would have to make, because the movie makes an abrupt switch in his character about two-thirds of the way through. Until then, he's been a gentle, goofy soul, an exotic outsider. Then Burton and his writer Caroline Thompson go on autopilot and paste in a standard Hollywood ending. You know what that is the hero and the villain meet. There is a deadly confrontation and no prizes for guessing who wins, except in pure action films. Situations used to be solved by dialogue and plot developments. No more. Now someone is killed and that's the solution. And the movie is over. In Edward Scissorhands, the villain is a neighborhood lout named Jim, played by Anthony Michael Hall, who does not like guys with scissors for hands, and picks on Edward until finally there is a trumped-up fight to the finish up at the castle. The conclusion is so lame it's disheartening. Surely anyone clever enough to dream up Edward Scissorhands should be swift enough to think of a payoff that involves our imagination. All of Burton's movies look great. PV Big Adventure was an unalloyed visual delight, and so was Beetlejuice, and Batman gave us a Gotham City that was one of the most original and atmospheric places I have seen in the movies. But should not there be something more? Some attempt to make the characters more than caricatures. All of the central characters in a Burton film, PV the Demon, Beetlejuice, Batman the Joker, or Edward Scissorhands, exist in personality vacuums. They are self-contained oddities with no connection to the real world. It's saying something about a director's work when the most well-rounded and socialized hero in any of his films is PV Herman. So there is a Edward Scissorhands movie review. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel and like this video. If you want to watch Edward Scissorhands movie, you will search it on Netflix, or you can search it on Amazon Prime Video. You will definitely search, and you will get this movie in any OTT platform. If you like this movie review, you can definitely subscribe our channel.